on Miller Street. It was a happy day for me. It was a sad day for her and a happy day for her. I was so glad that the Historical Society was agreeable to mark in this grave, because I felt that with the background that Horace King had and the wonderful talent he had in bridge building should have been recognized. And I'm happy that Troup County Historical Society had a part in getting that done.
One thing they didn't know then was his proper death date. Always before, we thought the death occurred in 1887. And when the archives first opened, we looked for his obituary in LaGrange newspapers, which we have for those years, and could never find it. And we thought that was odd, because we knew that even then people recognized Horace King's talents and sort of his genius. Later, purely by accident, we found out that he had actually died 2 years earlier in 1885. We'd gotten the 1887 date from a family Bible, which should be a good source, but it was probably recorded later. It may have been recorded by somebody who wasn't alive at the time. So once we found the actual date in 1885, we found obituaries in the LaGrange paper and in the Atlanta paper. One of the papers called him the Prince of Bridge Builders. So the cemetery sort of retains the 1887 date. So it's amazing how 100 years later you can still be correcting yourself.
Horace King would have been an exceptional and important man in the area if he had been a university graduate, the son of a rich family with a history of contracting. But he was a slave. He would have been important no matter what his background was, because he built the bridges that for some reason no one else seemed to be able to build. The people with money chose not to hire anyone else to build. He built the bridges that created the Chattahoochee Valley as a unified area. He also built a great many other bridges and other buildings. He was always in demand. He had fame and respect beyond the normal expectations of any brilliant, well-born white man, and yet he was a slave. As such, he becomes a sort of miraculous exception, an example of not, sad to say, not social change, not collective overcoming of prejudice, sad to say, but he's an example of how an individual somehow succeeded against all odds, against the system, and how also his friend, lost friend and former master, John Godwin, somehow all along the way facilitated and trusted and encouraged this.
I think my greatest appreciation of my great-grandfather came when he was inducted into the Engineers Hall of Fame.
I was fortunate enough to be invited to the University of Alabama, the Tuscaloosa campus, to accompany my father when he received an award for Horace King. He was inducted into the Alabama Engineering Hall of Fame.
For this high honor.
And we attended the ceremonies, and at that point I realized, oh my goodness, this man was a great man, and I didn't even know it.
On behalf of my great-grandfather, Horace King, I am proud to accept this award.
Horace King is simply a sort of a miracle. One man in a million, and as such a sort of example of what each of us, if we can become the one in a million, could possibly become.
They saw that bright young man standing waist-deep in the water, laying granite pillars in the Chattahoochee mud, and his hand marked the beams they would lay across the river. Bridge-building man, Horace King. The Chattahoochee River bordered Indian territory when Horace and his master came in 1832, but there were King bridges all up and down that muddy water before Horace King's work was through. And in every morning sun, he could see the chains about him. When shall the people of our earth be free? Born as a slave, Horace worked on what was given, the power to labor to be free. When Horace's work was done, he'd been in the legislature. He'd had houses and grandchildren and his name upon a street. And the glass by his bedside was rainbow-colored crystal. Heavenly bridge to Horace King. And in every morning sun, he could see the chains about him. When shall the people of our earth be free? And his hand marked the beams they would lay across the water, built him a bridge to Jubilee. A bridge-building man, Horace King.